calculation of three-phase balanced fault current. If the system is subjected to a three-phase fault, then how to find out the fault current? We are considering here two different cases. That is a case one that is pertaining to unloaded system. The system is excited, that is the voltage is applied. However, the system is not loaded, means it is unloaded system. Under this condition, how to find out the fault current? How to find out the fault current? And case number two, if the system is loaded, when there is a three-phase fault occurs, then how to find out the fault current? Under two different headings, we have to see how the calculations are made for a three-phase fault in a power system. First, I am considering here for unloaded system, there is generator which is connected to a transformer and it is connected to a transmission line, and the transmission line end, as such, there is no load is connected. But however, at the remote end of the transmission line, there is a three-phase fault is occurring. A three-phase fault is occurring on the unloaded power system. In that case, how to find out the fault current? Just I am explaining, we will come back to this particular slide once again. Just I am explaining this concept here. That is, I will draw once again the network with its symbols. That is a generator which is connected to a transformer and it is connected to a transmission line and it is unloaded. As such, there is no load is connected. Now if you are drawing the reactance diagram for this, the generator is represented by a reactance and source of voltage. The transformer is represented by its equivalent reactance. Similarly, the transmission line is also represented by the reactors. Now it is a transmission line. It is XTL. It is the transformer reactance. It is generator reactance. And it is the internal voltage of a generator. Now, if there is a fault occurs at the terminals of the transmission line, then there is a fault occurs here, means it is grounded. Means from here it is grounded. This is a short circuit, or you can call this as a fault here. We're calling this as a fault. Therefore, if we're drawing it, now the current which is flowing through this is called as the fault current IF. Then how to find out the fault current IF? The first step in this is you have to choose the first step in the procedure is that choose appropriate base quantities. Choose base quantities. That is MVAB and KVB in any one part of the circuit, or it is a mentioned in the numerical itself. That is, which part you have to take, the base, volt, ampere and voltage, and what value you have to take. Next step is the express the reactances, voltages to per unit value on new base quantity chosen, on new base quantities. Okay, then draw the reactance diagram. Okay, what I did is just I'm choosing a base value in any one part of the circuit, then on that base I'm converting all the reactances and per unit value of the voltage on the new base quantity. On a new base quantity, you have to convert all reactances and voltages to its per unit value. These are the new values of per unit reactance. Then there is a fault is occurring, therefore I am drawing this whole the reactance diagram. Just you have to simplify this, that is, all these reactances are connected in series, therefore you can replace all these reactants by a single reactance. Therefore, the voltage is easy as it is. Can call this as a plus and minus, and this is a total reactance. It is the total reactance. Total reactance, it is nothing but that is Xg plus Xt plus Xtl, and here there is a fault is occurring. Therefore, this is your fault current. This is a fault current. Just it is simple, the closed circuit, here source is voltage E, the reactance is X total, yes. Therefore, the current IF can easily be calculated. IF is equal to, it is Eg divided by, it is Xg plus Xt plus Xtl. That is, what you have to do is, to calculate the field fault current, you have to find out the what is the reactance up to the fault point. What is the reactance up to the fault point? That is, you have to divide that value to the voltage Eg, so that you are getting the fault current. Here, while calculating the reactance diagram, the value what you are getting here is per unit value. Then I am interested in the fault current in the actual value. Therefore, IF actual is equal to IF per unit multiplied by the base current. That gives the actual value of the fault current in terms of amperes. That we are getting in amperes. The procedure is very simple. Draw the reactance diagram the based on new base quantities. Find out the total reactance up to the fault point. That value you have to divide to the voltage, so that we are getting the fault current. That fault current is per unit value. If you want the actual value, just you have to multiply the base current. That is, the fault is occurring at this point. You have to find out what is the base current here, IB. You have to find out the base current IB. Then you have to multiply the base current IB here, so that you are getting the actual current. This is a procedure you have to adopt for calculating the fault current. The same thing is explained here. Just I will show you. See here. What I did is, it is easy as it is. That is the source of voltage. Then I combined all the reactants. That is the reactance of the generator, reactance of the XT, that is the transformer, and reactance of the transmission line. It is a total reactance. That is a single reactance I drawn for all these three, because all they are connected in series. And the fault is occurring at this point, therefore that point is grounded. Then the generator is also started from ground, therefore there is a fault current IF. The procedure is explained here, the same thing. Define the base voltage and the volt ampere. Okay, if the given, then well and good. Otherwise, you have to choose appropriate base voltage and base volt ampere. Usually in the numerical, they are giving the base quantities. Next, draw the single phase reactance diagram of the system and incorporate the values of components in per unit based on common base. Whatever the base were chosen in the first point, based on that you have to find out all the new quantities. Then find the short circuit current, that is IF is equal to Eg divided by X. That is Eg divided by total reactance X. Therefore, three phase short circuit current level in per unit. The three phase short circuit level is nothing but, it is the voltage multiplied by the fault current. That is, EC is also in per unit, the IF is also per unit, therefore what you are getting is three phase short circuit level, that is EC into I. That is, it is what we are getting here is, it is a per unit value of volt ampere. We are getting per unit value of volt ampere. Then you are getting volt ampere here. Suppose I want this of a three phase short circuit level in terms of the MVA, then what you have to do is you have to multiply base MVA. Just like it is, the per unit value is equal to actual value divided by base value. Therefore, the actual value, how we are getting? The first quantity, what we are getting is the per unit value. That is, it is the volt ampere is in terms of per unit we are getting. That is, actual value is the second value. That is how we are getting actual value. It is a per unit value multiplied by the base value. The same thing I did here. That is, EG IG is in terms of per unit. Here I am multiplying the base quantity so that I am getting an actual MV of the short circuit. This is how you have to calculate the short circuit MVA. Now, one important point you have to observe here, that is, voltage is one an angle of 0 degree, that is per unit value, because you are taking the base in this circuit only. One angle of 0 degree per unit, because the system is unloaded. Because the system is unloaded, you can take the voltage at any point of the circuit. It is remains the same, because as such there is no voltage difference, because everywhere it is one per unit value, because there is no drop. It is unloaded, and hence the system voltage in all the points is the nominal voltage that is one per unit. This is how you have to calculate the fault current, then you have to convert into the actual value. Just we'll look into the one particular problem. Just I am taking for the analysis purpose here. That is, the two bus system is shown in figure. Determine the total three phase fault current when system is unloaded. This system is given. Here there is a fault occurs. The system is under no load condition. He is given the base quantity as 75 MVA. And base kilovolt as 11 kV, that to in generator circuit. Then he is given the specification of the generators, transformers and the transmission line. Just you, what you have to do is, the first thing is, you have to choose the base quantity in this. That is, you have chosen, that is 75 MVA is given already, and that is 11 kV is the base quantity in this. And the base quantities in the transmission line side is also 75 MVA. It is remains same. Then this base voltage should be transferred to this side. It is 32 divided by 11 multiplied by 11. Therefore, it is 32 kV. Now we are getting the new base quantities here. The base quantities. Then we have what? The old quantity here, these are the old quantities. Then you have to convert the reactances of all the component to new base quantities. That I am performing here in the next slide. This network given, then this is a reactance, that is all the component are expressed on the base quantity of 75 MVA 11 kV in the generator circuit and 75 MVA 32 kilovolts in the transmission line circuit. Then you are finding out the reactances and drawn the reactance diagram. You can see here, to draw the reactance diagram, 1 and 2, these are the extreme end. They have to start from the ground. Therefore, these are started from the ground point. And the transformer, this is generator 1, that is first generator 1, it is connected to transformer, then it is connected to bus number 1. Similarly, generator 2 is also started from the ground and it is connected to its reactance of 0.3, then to the transformer T2, to the bus number 1. Then here the two transmission line, it is 150 kilometers and 0.2 ohm per phase per kilometer. You have to convert this into 450 kilometers in terms of ohm. Find out the base impedance in the circuit, actual value of impedance divided by base impedance, then what I am getting is 2.19 is the per unit value of the reactance of the transmission line. They are connected in parallel to this. And at this point, there is a fault occurs, therefore, fault is from that unloaded point to it is ground. If there is no fault, this link is not there, that is red link is not there, because it is unloaded condition. It is unloaded condition, means there is no current. Because of this short circuit, there is a fault current will flow. Next step is, you have to reduce this circuit, you have to reduce the circuit. The first step, what you can do is you can reduce by adding these two reactances. You can add these two reactances. They are in series. Similarly, you can add these two reactances. They are in the series. Okay. Then you are getting one reactance and one voltage source which is connected to the bus number 1. Bus number 1. Just you have to look into the next figure that I shown that particular reduction in the circuit. See here, what I did is I added these two reactances and these two are connected in parallel, then I am converting into a single unit. These are connected in parallel between two lines. Just I am finding out a single reactance here. These two I am added. Therefore, what I am getting here is the single resistance is 0.25. It is a combination of generator reactance plus transformer reactance. It is also generator 2 reactance plus transformer 2 reactance. This is a parallel combination reactance of the transmission line. It is as it is. Then one important point you have to see here in this is this particular point is at 1 per unit. It is at 1 per unit. This also at 1 per unit. They have got the equal potential of 1 per unit. Therefore, you can join these two points and you can replace these two source by a single source. It does not make any difference because it is also 1 per unit. It is at this point, it is 1 per unit. It is also at 1 per unit. Therefore, these two sources, they are having the same value, can be replaced by single reactance, and this terminal should be shorted here because it is at 1 per unit value. Okay, just I am showing in this figure, you can observe here. See here, that is, I am replacing these two by single the source. And these two 0.25 and 0.54, they are now coming parallel. Is it is in series with 0.095. Therefore, what I am doing here is, I am replacing, these two are in parallel. It is in series with this. Therefore, I am drawing a single network consisting of the voltage 1 per unit. And the total reactance of this network is 1.265. per unit reactance. Then you have to find out the fault current. The fault current is voltage divided by reactance, that is 1 divided by J1.265. That is what I am getting is, it is minus J0.79 per unit. What I am interested is only the magnitude of the current. Just you can to look into, it is a 0.79 per unit is a fault current. It is a per unit. I am interested in the actual value, therefore I am finding out the base, because the base quantity here is, the base quantity at this particular point is 75 MVA and 32 kilovolts. Based on that I am calculating the base current here. Then if you are multiplying the base current to the fault current, then what I am getting is, it is a actual fault current, it is 1069 amperes is the fault current.